Okay, so this time what I want to show you is how to read what we call an e-face staff. So when you buy an automatic level and the tripod, you'll get a staff, and generally nowadays it'll be one of these e-face types. So they're telescopic or collapsible if you like, and they fold down to be about 1 meter, 1.2 meters long, but depending on the type you buy, they can be up to 3 or 5 meters in height. Obviously that's fairly high, so when we use them we only open them up to the size that we need, the maximum size that we need, and generally one or two extensions will sort of do it. So the staff itself is broken up into these shapes. Every 100 mil you have a major marking. And so this is the 1 meter mark, and that measurement is actually the bottom side of this E shape, which is what gives the staff its name, the E type staff. So 100 is the underside of that mark. And obviously 1 meter, 100 or 1100 would be the underside of this mark. The E itself is 50 mil in height. And each leg of the E is 10 mil, and each gap is 10 mil. So that's 1 meter. Then this is going to be 1 meter and 10, 1 meter and 20, 30, 40, 50. So the E is 50 mil high. And then above that, each gap again is worth 10 mil. Each square is worth 10 mil. So 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. And then we were back up to the 1.1. So that's how you read it. Now, as far as what can we do in between the 10 mil, well, that's a little bit of guesstimation to actually figure out where the crosshairs of the instrument that you're using are hitting, and just you estimate exactly what your reading would be. So they're not terribly accurate, but they're accurate enough to do what we want to do. Now, when we look through the instrument, a couple of things we need to watch out for when we're reading the staff. So you can see here, this one, the crosshair, is set on the 1 meter line, but we want to make sure the person holding the staff is not leaning it towards or away from him. So the person looking through the instrument can control that. You can tell them to stand it back up again, push it away from them, pull it towards them to get it to stand up. So we don't want any of that. The other problem is, if they lean it away from the instrument, you're going to get an inaccurate reading. So at the moment, we're right on the 1 meter mark. If you lean the staff away, you can see we're reading 1 meter and 30. So we're 30 mil out, just because they've lent the staff away from them. Now, the person reading the instrument is going to have no idea about that. So that's up to the person holding the staff to make sure they keep it as plumb as possible. So don't lean it away. Keep it plumb. And that's pretty much it. That's the e-face staff. So the main points, the measurement, the written measurement's always the bottom of the E. The E itself is 50 mil in height, and each block or gap is worth 10 mil. And that's the e-face staff.